blessing us with iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad, Rasulullah. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا وأجل مسمى عنده ثم أنتم تمترون وهو الله في السماوات وفي الأرض يعلم سركم وجهركم ويعلم ما تكسبون. All praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth and the originator of darkness and light. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides will never be misguided. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to be misguided, no one can ever guide him. And I ask Allah to send his peace and blessings upon his last prophet and messenger, our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his companions, upon his followers, and upon those who stick to the straight path until the day of judgment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all from among them. Ameen. We're going to be talking about the revealed wisdom. And what do we mean by that? We mean by that something that is revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and is something that it was described as a wisdom. And that is, or these are the sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're going to choose some of these gems from the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, some of these beautiful sayings of our last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we're going to reflect upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Najm about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, وَمَا يَنطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, that he does not speak out of his own whims. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Indeed, it's a revelation revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why when one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and he asked, he said, O Prophet of Allah, I write everything that you say, but people ask me to stop doing so. So should I continue writing what you say or should I stop? So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told him, Uktub, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا الْحَقِّ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam told him, write, for indeed nothing comes out of my mouth except the truth. Nothing comes out of his mouth alayhi salatu wasalam except the truth. Why? Because what he says, alayhi salatu wasalam, is part of the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal also describes what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says as the wisdom. And that is why Allah azza wa jal says in the Holy Quran to the wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, وَذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And remember, or mention, مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنْ, that is which is recited in your houses, from the verses of Allah and the wisdom. And what does the wisdom here mean? It means the sayings of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And that is why we find that the wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us about his traditions, things that will only be found in the house of the Prophet, and things that no one knows about except the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, people who are very close to him. How he prayed, for example, at night. How he interacted with his family ﷺ. How beautifully he used to treat his daughter, for example, Fatima. May Allah be pleased with her. And so on and so forth. This is part of this wisdom. So we're going to be, inshallah ta'ala, reflecting upon some of these wisdoms from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I want you to also remember something. It is from the blessing of Allah azza wa jal upon this ummah is that he saved for us not only the recited words of the Quran, meaning just the scripture in the sense of the preservation of the words of it, but rather Allah azza wa jal also from his wisdom and from his generosity and from his mercy upon mankind is that he also preserved the actual manifestation of these words. And that is why when Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, when she was asked by one of the companions, she was asked, how is the character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How's his character? So she said, Do you read the Quran? They said, Yes, we read the Quran. Aisha radiallahu anha said, Kana khuluquhu al-Quran. The character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was the Quran. Meaning when the Prophet alayhi wasallam reads a verse in the Quran, or when it is revealed to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a verse about forgiving other people, for example, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Immediately you see that in the actions of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and these very actions are also preserved to us. When it's revealed to him, أُتْلُو, recite. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم recites the Holy Quran. When the Prophet ﷺ, it's revealed to him, أُدْعُو إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ, call to the way of your Lord. You see that the Prophet ﷺ calls to the way of his Lord. So the words of the Quran are preserved, but also the manifestation, the actual actions of the Prophet ﷺ, the embodiment, if you would say, of the Quran is also preserved. And this is from the mercy of Allah. So we're going to be reflecting again on some of these revealed wisdoms, some of the words of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And one of the first words of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that I want all of us to reflect upon is the saying of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Man salla alayya salatan wahidatan sallallahu alayhi biha ashra. That whoever sends one salah upon me, if you just say Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabiyina Muhammad, if you send one salah on the Prophet alayhi salam, Allah Almighty from his generosity will send upon you 10 salawat. But what does this salawat mean? When we say Allahumma salli ala nabiyina Muhammad, this salah means basically that you are praying for the Prophet alayhi salam. You are asking Allah Almighty to mention the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to exalt the mentioning of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam with the inhabitants of heaven. And we know that when we mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal also mentions us, as it was narrated in the hadith, man dhakarani fi mala, dhakartuhu fi mala in khayrin minhum. Whoever mentions me in a group of people, I will mention him in a better companionship or in a better group. And what is that group? It is the groups of the angels in heaven. So we're basically asking Allah to praise His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We also ask Allah to send the blessings and the peace upon the Prophet alayhi wasallam and the al of the Prophet alayhi wasallam, which means the followers of the Prophet alayhi wasallam, and especially the family of the Prophet Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's peace and blessings be upon him. Now, this command to send the peace and the blessing on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is something which Allah azza wa jal mentions in the Holy Quran. Allah Almighty says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ, that indeed Allah and His angels, they all send the peace and the blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, all you who believe, صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ, send the salah upon him, pray upon him, alayhi salatu wasalam, that Allah praises him, meaning to the great inhabitants of heaven. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ, indeed Allah and his angels send the salah upon the Prophet. Then Allah commands us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, all you who believe, صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا, send this salah upon him and this taslim, this peace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, what are the benefits of sending the salah on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There is a very important concept that I want all of us to keep in mind. And that is when you pray for someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gives you a similar reward. For example, when you pray to your brother or sister, you say, Oh Allah, forgive them. Oh Allah, bless their efforts. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give them righteous children, and so on and so forth. The Prophet ﷺ tells us that there is an angel who says, وَلَكَ بِمِثْلِ, like for you is the same. May Allah give you the same. So imagine if you are praying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. Imagine how many blessings you are going to be getting. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one time was asked by one of his companions. That companion had some sort of a dua, some sort of a supplication that he used to make for himself. And then he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, O Prophet of Allah, I have this dua that I make for myself and so forth, but I want to also send the salah upon you. So how much should I dedicate for the salah upon you? And how much should I dedicate for just praying for myself? Would half be enough? The Prophet ﷺ told him, it's good, but if you increase, it would be better. So he asked the Prophet ﷺ, what if I increase it by such and such? The Prophet ﷺ tells him, it's good, but if you increase on the salah upon me, it would be even better. So he says to the Prophet ﷺ, should I just make all of my dua, all of my supplications, just praising you, meaning sending the salah and the salam upon you? The Prophet ﷺ tells him, إِذَنْ يَكْفِيكَ اللَّهُ هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرُ ذَنْبُكْ. That if you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of whatever is worrying you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your sins. So when you send the salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid, اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. This is a key that you're using for the blessings of Allah to descend upon you, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you your sins, and so that any kind of worry that is worrying you, it will disappear by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, I am going to share with you a very small story, but I think that it's time for a little break. So I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, go for a little break, but I want you to stay with me. And after the break, I'm going to tell you the little story. So stay with us, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Islam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, and welcome back. We were talking about some of the virtues of sending the salah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The virtues of saying, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innak hamidun majid. The salah which every Muslim memorizes, and it is part of your salah. You say it every time you pray. And I promised you that I was going to share with you a story. It's a story from one of the scholars of our time. He's the Imam of the Quba Masjid in the Medina, or the city of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I heard this story from his mouth. He said that one time I had some kind of a heart problem and I had to have an open heart surgery. And he said, alhamdulillah, the surgery went very well, everything went smooth and so forth. And I got out of the ICU, the intensive care unit and so forth. They took me back to my room, everything was stable. And then he said that all of a sudden, things started to go wrong, everything is beeping. And he said, I got really worried. And he was more worried when the room was filled with doctors. And he's even worrier when the head doctor, the head of the team, told him, I'm sorry, Sheikh, we'll have to take you back again to the surgery room and we have to open your heart again because there is some kind of a collection of blood basically in your chest. The man said that I was so saddened and I didn't know what to do. And I just said, yani, alhamdulillah. And when the doctors left the room, he said there was one nurse left. A nurse who didn't even look that religious. He said she looked at me and she said to me, his name is Sheikh Saleh. She said to him, Sheikh Saleh, or she just said to him, Saleh, you know what? Just send the salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and everything will be okay. You know, layperson's advice, say the salah on the Prophet and everything will be okay, everything will be fine. So he said, I said, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Oh Allah, send the salah upon your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his companions and upon his family. And he said, by Allah, he swears by Allah, that blood that was collecting, it all just disappeared and it came out immediately on the spot. And he said, I immediately remembered this saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to one of his companions, that if you send the salahs upon me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yakfika ma ahammak. Allah will take care of whatever is worrying you, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. He said, the head doctor came again and he said, ya Shaykh, say alhamdulillah, because Allah azza wa jal saved you from that surgery. The Shaykh also had a nice comment on this story. He said, I am the Imam of the Masjid of Quba, the Masjid in the city of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, people point at me as a great scholar and so on and so forth. And he said, I completely forgot about this fact. And this woman, who does not look even religious at all, reminded me of that. So he had a nice lesson also, and he said, never ever belittle people or their advices. My dear brothers and sisters, sending the salah on the Prophet ﷺ will bring a lot of barakah, a lot of blessings in your lives. When you hear the name of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, get used to saying sallallahu alayhi wasallam immediately. May Allah send the peace and the blessings upon him. Because when the Prophet ﷺ asked his companions, who's the stingy person? Who's the miserly person? He said ﷺ that it is the one whom when I am mentioned, he does not send the salah upon me. And in another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ climbed his pulpit, you know, the steps of it, to get up and give a talk. And whenever he takes one step, he will say, Ameen, may Allah accept. Then again, he will say, Ameen, may Allah accept. Then again, he will say, Ameen, may Allah accept. So the companions asked the Prophet ﷺ, why are you saying Ameen, Ameen, Ameen every time you climb these steps? He said, Angel Gabriel was making a supplication, a dua. And as we all know, that Angel Gabriel is the head of all the angels. So he was making dua that whoever reaches the month of Ramadan and he does not gain the forgiveness of Allah, رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ, may he perish. And that whoever has his parents, both of them, or one of them alive, but they do not cause him to enter paradise, meaning he does not treat them well, so that he enters paradise because of his nice treatment to them, may that person perish. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Ameen. And whoever so hears the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he does not send the salah upon him, may he perish. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his peace and his blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, there are important times where we should send the salah on the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. One of these times is actually the time that we are doing this beautiful recording for Peace TV. It is actually a Friday, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that إِنَّ مِنْ خَيْرِ أَيَّامِكُمْ يَوْمَ الْجُمُعَةِ فَأَكْثِرُوا عَلَيَّ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ فِيهِ. He said that one of your best days is the day of Friday. So send upon me much salah. So you say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad and so forth, as much as you can, especially on these Fridays. Another occasion where we should send the salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we mentioned before, is when the name of the Prophet ﷺ is mentioned. A third occasion is when we are making supplications, when we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was reported that a man entered the mosque and he started to ask Allah azza wa jalla immediately for his need. For example, oh Allah, I need such and such, oh Allah, give me such and such, oh Allah. So the Prophet ﷺ called him and he taught him one of the beautiful manners of supplicating to Allah, of asking Allah. He told him, when you basically make supplication, when you make dua, ihmadillah, praise Allah first. and then send the salah on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then your supplication inshallah will be accepted by Allah Almighty. So another person comes and he sends the peace and he praises Allah Azza wa Jal, and then he sends the peace and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he asks Allah for his need. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, أيها الداعي سل تجب. O supplicant, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah Almighty will send his peace and blessings upon you, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will actually answer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your invocation, your supplications. So when we want to ask Allah Azza wa Jal, it is good to start by praising Allah, by sending the salah on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And as we mentioned, another occasion where sending the salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is actually obligatory, and this is when we are in our salawat, when we're doing our 5 daily prayers. It is part of our salah to send the peace and the blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. There are a few types of sending the salah on the Prophet ﷺ, different ways of sending the salah. Now obviously we are excluding the innovated ways. There are certain groups that made innovated ways on sending the salah on the Prophet ﷺ. So let's put these on the side. And let us only look at the narrations that were narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on sending the salah on the Prophet alayhi wasallam. One of them, for example, mentions the wives and the family of the Prophet when it says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi. Or Allah send the peace and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon his wives, upon the progeny of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it behooves the Muslim brothers and sisters, try to go back to these authentic sources, for example, the book of Riyad al-Saliheen or any other authentic book of hadith, and learn the different ways of sending the peace and the blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let me conclude with one point, and that is, you could ask yourself and you say, what does praising the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam have to do with accepting my supplication? Why shouldn't I just make my supplication directly? And we say that when you want something from someone, let's say you want something, and this used to happen especially in the past when people would go to kings and so forth, they will start to praise them, okay? And then the king will give them what they need without even them asking for what they needed. And likewise, when you say the salah on the Prophet ﷺ, when you praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you know the status of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with Allah Almighty and how much Allah loves it, when you praise his Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah also will take care of your worries and Allah will forgive you your sins. We ask Allah to forgive all of our sins, and we ask Allah to send his peace and his blessings upon his last prophet and messenger, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon his companions, and upon those who follow the prophetic guidance. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with life, blessing us with Islam, blessing us with Iman. Thank you, Allah, for blessing us with Muhammad Rasulullah. Everything